Hello, great YouTubers. Welcome back. In this lesson, we will look at how to access symbol factory and also how to get advanced symbols from the symbol factory. Let's get started. Kindly subscribe if you've not done that already and also press on the notification bell. Please show me some love by clicking on the like button. Okay. All right. So basically in this section, we'll be looking at the symbol factory. So to do this, we'll go to the wizard and then have a look at where the symbol factory is. So we can see symbol factory labeled here. Okay. So to launch the symbol factory, we need to select the symbol that is indicating here and then we click on okay. And then we can, in our working space, we can just click anywhere in our working space and this will automatically open the symbol factory window. Okay, so why do we need symbol factory? The symbol factory has a lot of symbols in there that makes life easy and then makes your design and your work in the interscader very simple. So let's say for instance in the previous tutorials we've been picking the symbols directly from the wizard, but let's say if you want to add conveyors, if you want to add tanks, if you want to add symbols like trees, computer accessories and other stuff, you can see that you can't get it directly from the wizard and you can only get these things when you use the symbol factory. So it can see that we have the 3D push buttons and a lot of push buttons that we have here, different types that we can indeed mimic exactly what we want to do. We have air conditioning symbols, we have architectural symbols, we can go down, we have basic shapes, we have boilers, and we can see that we have different types. Let's say if you want conveyor belts, you can come to conveyors and you can see that we have different types of conveyors here. So that's the purpose of the symbol factory. It gives you an exposure to a lot of symbols that you can make use during your design phase. Okay, so for now we can pick this conveyor belt and then we can put it on our workspace. We can extend it. Okay, good. So we have our conveyor belt and you can see that we got this conveyor belt directly from the symbol factory. We can add other items, let's say like sensors. So if I right click and go to repeat last object, it would send me directly to the symbol factory and then I can pick other stuff from there. Okay, so I can move on. We have electrical stuffs. Okay, so we can move on. We can go to sensors. SS. Okay, and at the sensor page we can see a lot of sensors there. We want a proximity sensor, so we can go in for this. We click on okay. Okay, so we can see that we have a sensor that we can position. We can go in there and pick a motor as well. So I'll go back to the wizard and then symbol factory again. And then I click on OK. And then if I go to M, I can look for machines, motors. Motors, okay. So I can pick different forms of motors. Let's say I need this type of motor, so I click on it. Okay, good. So basically from the symbol factory you can pick a lot of items. I can then right click again and go to repeat last and then I can pick some containers. Okay, so you do our demonstration with a bottle. So perfect. All right, so now we have our conveyor. Now we've been able to fetch it from the symbol factory. We have a motor that will indicate whenever our conveyor is running, and then we have our sensor and then the bottle. Okay, so now how do we apply animations to these particular items that are from the symbol factory? You can see that with this one, immediately I click, I can come to this section and then I can apply a bit of animation to it in the properties. But with this, That is the symbols from the symbol factory. Immediately I double click, it sends me back to the symbol factory page. So which means it does not give me access to the properties to apply animation or other control stuff to it. If I also right click and come to properties, it sends me back to the symbol factory page. So how do we achieve this? How can we apply properties to this particular item so that we can either blink or we can either change the states of those designs? Okay, to do this you need to right click and then you come to cell symbols and then you go to brick cell. Immediately you click on the brick cell, then it will be broken and then you will be able to access the animation properties. So we can see that we have color, we have fill, we have text, we have object, we have locations that we can apply to it. So with this assigned, then we can apply locations to it to move it or to blink it whenever the bottle is at a specific position. Perfect. So we would like to apply the same thing to this particular jug. So we go to cell symbol, we go to brick cell, and then immediately you do that, you see that you'll be able to access the property. The same thing, because we would like to have the motor blink whenever we start the conveyor system. So we go to cell and then brick. Perfect. So we can also assign animation to this particular property for the conveyor, because we will not be applying any animation to it. We will leave it as it is without breaking. Okay, good. So we've been able to break so that we can access the properties of the items that we brought from the symbol factory. But you can see the difference between items from the symbol factory and the ones that are here or picked directly from the wizard. So if I draw this box and I double click on it, you see that automatically I have access to apply controls to it. But from the symbol factory, you need to go to cell symbol and then you break cell before you can have access to the property interface. Good. Kindly try your hands on this. I will see you in the next tutorial. Thank you. Bye bye.